Next week, he had a solution for that. He asked his friend John to bring these keys that don't have to be dug into. Some of his friends brought a hammer to hammer the tea into the bell. And one guy even brought a drill. Believe it or not, a drill. They would drill a hole and then put the tea in. Then was not to read that. At this moment, we're all in a state of shock, and it's going to hurt for a while. But instead of mourning the long life that could have been, let us celebrate the memories that he gave us. I'm sure this is what he would have wanted. We remember him as an accomplished marketing professional and a math teacher who taught all over the world. We remember him for his wicked sense of humor that was always on. He always had a smile that he was thinking about something. From hundreds of silly emails, which I still have, laying jokes on the golf course, he was always having fun. Remember him for his dedication to the family, especially his parents, and how he only took jobs that allowed him to visit his dad. But I think most importantly, you would remember him with the relationship with his dad. He had a group of friends from, I don't know, 4 years from his dad. He still gets together. And another group of friends from Cambridge, from another one from his North Cap, and of course, lots and lots of people from his golf. And he was so generous with that. In everything he did, they all gave back. So during his illness, we asked some people to help out with some drive. And so many people signed up. I had to build this bridge to keep track of them. From Mike Bouchard this year, to Ron Sutherland, to Tommy, and even Teresa, Ed. Everybody stepped up and we met on board. Towards the end, one person, especially that close to him, despite having a million things to do, she always was there for standing by. She too had a passion for God that rivaled them. And she is quite Polish. No wonder she's qualified to take over as the new commission. You all know what I'm talking about. Before I pass it over to Joy, let me say a word or two about Bonnie. We only got to know her well as we dealt with scandals. It is rare to find a partner so dedicated, so hardworking, and so resourceful. She gave up all she had, put up the fight for Stan. And when it became obvious that this is a fight he was going to lose, she did everything to make him come. An ordinary person would have fallen apart a long time. Stan was fortunate to have her, and we are fortunate to have her in our life. And one more thing. Bonnie was the one who signed up Stan for the golf lessons that have produced such wonderful friendships in them.
Well, that's going to be hard to follow. And probably you also made it to the last three nights. Stan Kopec and Bonnie Kopec. My new special friend. We played golf together for many years, but really only got to know each other well when I started driving Stan's radiation. We didn't talk about the Red Sox at all. Golf, but we need to talk about something different. We talked about our shared interest and love on those drives to Burlington. Stan and I share a love of math. I'm also a teacher. Students, teaching, health and exercise, travel and family, and oh yes, cats. Stan has three, and so do I. Stan told me stories about taking care of his mom and dad, and I told him stories about taking care of my mom, who just passed recently at the age of 101, and lived with us. But most importantly, we are both Poles. I'm thinking that Stan would like me to include a few numbers here. I took a little research and found out that there are 35 million people in the world that speak Polish. So Stan knew what I was talking about when we were up on the green and I said, Hot tutaj, jak się masz, and cicho, which meant, close your mouth, finish up your coffee, and hit the ball. When Stan and I talked about planning the first golf event ever, 4 or 5 years ago, Stan was overly concerned on would we have the right food. And I would say, Stan, you plan the golf, I'll plan the food. Wanted to be sure that we had kielbasa, kapusta, and an assortment of Polish food. I said, no problem, no problem. Come to my house, we'll have some Polish food. When it came time to eat, Stan filled up his plate with just that. Stan, what are you doing? I made all this Polish food. He said, I'm watching my weight. I was cooking for him. We'll miss our friend Stan and brother Stan, of course, always humble, always kind, with a welcoming smile. So I thought today, I thought it gave me the idea that before we leave, it would be time for all of us to learn a little Polish and say thank you, Stan, for being our friend. So we need to say dziękuję, Stasiu.
Dziękuję, Stasiu.
And also, I love you. Got all of you.
Got that.
I love you, Stan. You were so bad. Is that when you're crying? But we have to have a Polish blessing. May your hand be outstretched to all you meet. May all men say brother when they speak of you. May the land be fertile beneath your feet. May your days be gentle as the sun kissed you.